Hello, everyone. My name is Danny Hodder. I'm a Senior Program Manager at the Excel team in Microsoft. And this course is going to be about analyzing and visualizing data in Excel. Actually, I'm going to use Excel 2016. So originally, it was supposed to be with Excel 2016. But we decided to just call it with Excel because you'll be able to follow this not only with Excel 2016, but also with Excel 2013 and with some a little bit more difficulty with also with Excel 2010. Now I'm going to be covering areas of importing data into Excel, creating models of data in Excel, and using new tools that were added to Excel in the last versions. Let's go straight into our first module. And in this module, actually, I'm going to show you things which are not necessarily new. I'm going to show you data analysis using data in Excel, in the grid of Excel. And most of it will be hopefully familiar to you, but I'm going to cover it and then show the differences between this classic way of analyzing data and the new tools that I'm going to show you in further modules. So let me open my first file here and in Excel, and let's understand how people were doing or are doing data analysis in Excel for years. All right, so what do you see here? Is at least my take on a classic dashboard with Excel. It has three pivot charts, two slicers right here, three pivot charts, and the slicers are connected to all the pivot charts. So if I click here on accessories, all the three charts respond. I can select one, I can select multiple, and the data for this, what you see here is actually I can unhide some of the data here, and you'll see that actually all the data is right here in Excel. The data came into Excel, and let me unhide also the others because there are multiple tables here that contain the data. And this is kind of typical that the data is contained in a few ranges in Excel. But the author who created this report needed to combine all the data into one consecutive range of data, because a pivot table or a pivot chart, like I was using here, needs all the data to be in one range. So the first columns here going all the way from A to E are the original data that are sales transactions. And then all the columns coming from F to L are columns that are actually bringing data from the other tables into this table to make it one big table. So, and for that, the Excel user uses one of the oldest tools in Excel, the VLOOKUP function. So this is bringing, actually using two VLOOKUPs, this is bringing using another VLOOKUP. And VLOOKUP, I will not go into the details of explaining to you how to use VLOOKUP because this is not really the purpose of this course to teach you about VLOOKUP, but just as a quick reminder, VLOOKUP provides a key to another table. In this case, it's the customer, and then the table is the customer's table, and then it tells it, in this case, to bring column number 5, and false tells the VLOOKUP expression to look for an exact match and not just a non-exact match. Now, it may seem a little different from all the VLOOKUPs that you saw before. If you haven't been using tables in Excel, in this example, I'm using tables. This is why it's formatted this way. And also, this is why the expressions use column names instead and table names instead regular reference to Excel. If you don't use tables, I would recommend really to look at it. They've been around for quite some time in Excel, since 2007, and they are a great tool and makes for much more readable formulas and also easier to maintain formulas. Now, let's go back to our dashboard. So pretty much you see that I can get nice results. The dashboard, at least to my standards, looked pretty nice. So what's wrong in this picture, and why did we need to introduce new tools into Excel in the latest versions that go beyond what I was able to do here? So the challenges here are the following. First of all, this need to combine all the data together with VLOOKUP, it has its flaws or its problems. First of all, VLOOKUPs can get very slow. Let me give you an example here. If for any reason I go to the customer's table that I bring data from into the main table, the sales table, and if I go here and I just change one cell, let's say this guy, marital status of this customer changed from single to married, also means that this guy married. If you notice in the bottom, in the status line, it says calculating, and it has a progress bar, going, still going, and only now all the calculations were actually completed. The reason that it's a simple operation of a changing one cell took so long is because this range is used in thousands and thousands of VLOOKUP expressions, and all of them needed to be calculated. So VLOOKUPs can be slow, and this is slow. It can be actually a lot slower. Another VLOOKUPs can also be difficult to maintain and can be error prone. Another problem is that the data that we use is not always as simple as this one here. The only problem was to combine it to one range. But many times I need to do more operations on the data to manipulate, to shape it, to make it ready to be used in analysis. And in order to do that, the Excel user had some tools. You could use manual copy and paste operations. You can create some macros if you knew how to. You can use SQL to manipulate the data on the SQL side if you knew how to. But none of these solutions was really easy and accessible for Excel users. And if you did some manual operations, you had to repeat them every period. Let's say if the report is weekly, you had to repeat this every week. And this became really, really tedious, and people really do not like it. So manipulating and making the data ready to go is another thing. The third one is scale. The Excel grid is a maximum of 1 million rows. And for many cases, this is not enough. And even if you go to 500,000 and still have columns with VLOOKUP, it will be terribly slow. So the scale, being able to manipulate millions of rows, is not something that a regular Excel user would be able to do with regular Excel like this. So in order to solve this issues, and another one that I want to mention is that some data sources are not really accessible to native Excel. So some modern data sources, let's say if data is coming from Facebook, from Salesforce, from other, from OData, some of them are really not accessible to Excel, and people want to use a large variety of data sources. To solve all these problems, we actually, since 2010, have been providing new tools to Excel to be able to, first of all, create pivot tables and pivot charts without needing to combine them physically into one large range. So staying with multiple tables that you can use and you create pivot tables directly from. Creating, having a way to manipulate the data in very powerful ways and in a repeatable way. You do it once, you shape the data. Next time you need to import the same data, you just click on a button and it does everything for you. So this is the second thing. Scale, being able to get into Excel millions and millions of rows, even tens of millions if you need to, is another thing, and with very, very good performance. And the last one, which I actually haven't mentioned as a deficiency, is about creating logic, business logic. Here I'm using just one example. If you see here on this chart on the right side, there is a margin percent. It's a dual axis chart. On one side it's showing the margin percent and the other the revenue. The margin percent is calculated from the revenue and the cost with something called calculated field for the pivot table. I won't even go and show it to you exactly how to do that. It's been there in Excel for many, many years. But using calculated fields is very limited. The level of sophistication for the business logic you can create is very limited. And the new tools that I'm going to show you will make it possible for you to create really, really sophisticated business logic and do the calculations in a language that is similar to Excel, but extends the capabilities of Excel. So this is what we're going to do in the latest, in the all the other modules coming from here, I will show you the new tools, the new data model in Excel, the new language for calculations, the new tools for querying and shaping the data. So this is end of this module, and you should expect in the next modules to learn about these new tools that are available now for doing data analysis and visualization in Excel. Thank you, and see you next time.